Hello everyone, welcome to the semicolon. In this series, Deep Learning with Python, we'll be understanding and implementing a lot of deep learning algorithms. In this tutorial, we'll go ahead and set up our development environment so that it is easy for us to implement the deep learning algorithms we learn. We'll be using Tensorflow and Keras. Tensorflow is an open source library for numerical computations. It was developed by engineers working on the Google Brain team, which is Google's machine learning team. And TensorFlow is little less intuitive and difficult to work for beginners. So to solve this problem and focus on the actual thing, which is architecture of our deep learning model and understanding these deep learning algorithms, we'll abstract TensorFlow with Keras. Now, Keras is another open source library which helps in removing all the complexities of TensorFlow and similar libraries like Theano. It runs with either TensorFlow or Theano on the backend and provides us with simple and intuitive APIs for implementing deep learning algorithms. So, to use TensorFlow and Keras, we install Anaconda. Anaconda is a package which provides Python and most of its libraries used for machine learning pre-installed. So let's go ahead and download Anaconda. Type Anaconda on Google, click on the first link, and then click on download. Since NumPy has recently dropped support for Python 2.7, I suspect the other libraries to follow it in near future. So let's stay future-proof and download Python 3.6. I'll be downloading the 64-bit version, but you have to download it according to your machine's specification. And once downloaded, start the installation and wait for it to complete. So, Anaconda gives us a very easy way to install and manage libraries. It has pip, which is Python package manager, and also it has conda, which is kind of installation manager for Anaconda. So Anaconda lets you have different environments, just like sandboxes. So you can install different sets of libraries in different environments according to your need. For now, we'll be using a default environment. So while this is being installed, let's look at how we install TensorFlow and Keras in Windows. I do not have a NVIDIA GPU, so I'll be using the CPU version of TensorFlow. The best way is to follow the instructions given by the official website. And TensorFlow says we can install it for Anaconda by typing pip3 install upgrade TensorFlow. That's it, that simple. But when I type it, Python doesn't recognize pip3. Anaconda doesn't recognize pip3. So let me just type pip instead of pip3 and we're done. So this is installing TensorFlow. And when the installation is done, we will need some sample code to check if TensorFlow is working. So we can find this code on its official website itself. So let's just wait for the installation to finish and then I'll type the code as shown in the website. And remember, you don't have to understand any part of this code. We'll just check it if it's working. We won't have to understand this TensorFlow's code until later in this tutorial, where we'll be starting to learn. So not big of a problem, just check if it's working, because we need TensorFlow working for Keras to be working, and Keras is very simple and intuitive. And once we get hang of it, we'll be starting with TensorFlow. In the same Anaconda command prompt, type IDLE, and this will open a Python integrated development environment or a Python IDE, where you can type in your code and you'll see the output. So once you type the code and see the output, you can be sure that your TensorFlow installation has been completed and it is correctly installed. So for Keras, we can type pip install Keras, but sometimes the problem with pip is it doesn't work because of various compatibility issues. So we use conda install Keras instead and this works. So conda will uninstall the libraries with conflicting version and install the version required. So for now, we can just wait for the installation to complete, and it's this simple for us to install libraries with Anaconda. Now to check if the installation works, we need some sample code again, and we can get the sample code through the website, or let's just import a library from Keras. Let's import sequential from Keras models. So open command prompt and then type IDLE. And when that environment opens, type from keras.models import sequential. And wait for it to complete. For the first time, this may take a lot of time. So, and oops, this has failed. And it says Theano is not installed. So now when you install Keras, you get two choices, either Theano or TensorFlow. And TensorFlow has stopped its development because there are many other libraries. That's what they say. So we've chosen TensorFlow over it. And that is why we need to inform Keras that we will be going ahead with TensorFlow. So this will help us stay future-proof. For that, we need to follow certain steps. So open My Computer in Windows, or if you're not using Windows, open the keras.json file wherever it is located. It is generally in the home folder. For Windows, it is in my computer user and the folder with your PC name. In that, open the .keras folder and then open keras.json file. The keras.json file is a config file for Keras. Here you can change the backend from Theano to TensorFlow. And the image dimension ordering is also set to TH, which is Theano style of image representation, in which the color comes first. We can change it to TF later on, which will mean representing color last. So images are represented through a 3D matrix of either length width color or color length width. So these formats are accepted by NumPy. And after changing it, close the Anaconda command prompt and open it again. Type the same code, and this time it works perfectly. Oh, this throws an error, but that was due to a typing mistake. Sorry. Now changing it to keras.models work perfectly fine. And there we have it, our fully working environment of TensorFlow plus Keras. So we'll be starting on with this environment using Keras right from the next tutorial, when we'll be learning various algorithms. And later on in this tutorial, in this series, we'll be using TensorFlow. So I have lots of videos coming up. Subscribe to the channel for more videos. Thank you.